So I'm using this Blue Heaven primer to set my use on my T-zone, and this is a oil-free primer, really mattifying. So yeah, now I'm using the Blue Heaven eyebrow definer, and this is a really good eyebrow pencil. This has a rectangular tip, and this also comes with a spoolie, so it is really easy to draw those hair-like strokes and then comb your eyebrows. This is a one done kind of project for your eyebrows. So yeah, I'm just filling my eyebrows. Now I'm using this Inside Cosmetics Second Skin foundation. This is a really light to medium. This gives like a very natural kind of finish, and this has a dewy finish. So if you are like looking for a BB cream or something like a tinted hydrator or some sort of product, this is a really good product. I will recommend this if you have dry skin. This gives such a dewy skin like finish. I will zoom you out in a sec. So this barely has any coverage. So as you can see, I was breaking out a lot, so I have to just layer this product like thrice to cover some of my acne scars. This has a really sheer to sheer medium coverage, really good for that no makeup look. And I'm also taking it like on my neck. I will zoom you in a second so to show like how this looks like up close. So yeah, as you can see, this barely gives some coverage, very dewy, very hydrating. The finish is very natural. So if you want something for everyday look, this is a really good product. So yeah, now I'm taking the Inside Cosmetics concealer palette, and I'm taking the banana shade to highlight my under eyes to cover up my dark circles. This concealer is like really, really hydrating, creamy, and this legit feels like a butter. Like the texture, when you will touch it, you will feel like it is like a butter. You're touching a butter. It's really, really creamy. So I will recommend this to only dry skin people. I don't know how this will look on oily skin. So yeah, first time as a dry skin person, I'm able to find product that works for me, which are so inexpensive. So I am taking now the skin tone shade and covering my pigmentation around my mouth. And if you want to cover your acne scar, your pigmentation around your mouth, always use a concealer of your skin tone. That will help conceal every darkness around your mouth, your acne scars, and yeah. Now I'm taking the lightest concealer of this palette and just applying it all over my eyelid. So if you have a really light shade of concealer, use them as your eyeshadow base. Your eyeshadow will really look pigmented and they will pack a punch. So if you want extra pigment out of your eyeshadow, do use this trick. Now I'm going to just take that concealer over my on my neck as well, because the foundation was barely giving any coverage and my neck was looking way darker than my face. So yeah. So now I'm going to take the bronzer and apply it on my cheekbones and over my forehead. As you can see, this bronzer was looking really, really natural, and this was just blending really well, and this gave me like the natural tan effect, like I'm you know, tan naturally. So yeah, applying that over my nose as well. Now I'm going to take this to contour my cheekbones, or contour my jawline as well. So as you can see, just one concealer palette is, you know, so useful for bronzing, for contouring, highlighting, everything. Now I'm going to take this Chariot blush, and this is a cream blush, and my shade is nude. The only thing is, the blush was not looking that pigmented on camera. In person it was looking good, but on camera, to show you guys the actual shade, I have to apply this 4-5 times so that it will be visible on camera, as you can see. So I have applied it 4-5 times. I'm also taking it on my nose. I do like, you know, a within sort of blushing effect. So I do apply blush on my nose as well. So yeah, now for highlighter, I'm going to take the Insight Cosmetic highlighter in the shade Rose Gold, and this gives such a natural within sort of a glow. So even if you will apply it 10 times, this will still look really natural. This is such a good highlighter for that no makeup makeup look, and this just gives you that, you know, within sort of glowing effect, and I do really like it how this looks on skin. And since this is a cream highlighter, this does not emphasize, you know, those texture onto your, you know, cheeks. This just looks so natural. So yeah, now I'm taking the loose powder from Blue Heaven, and I'm setting my entire face. I usually don't set my entire face since I have a dry skin, but since every product was like cream, concealer, contour, blush, highlighter, my face was like literally like chip-chipa sort of, so I set my entire face. Usually I set just the T-zone, but since everything was so creamy, I have to upset the entire face. So for bronzer, I'm going to take this Fit Me blush, Fit Me Compact, in the deepest shade available in India, and this is the shade Coffee. And as you can see, you know, this shade is so perfect for my skin tone, you know, as a bronzer. So I use this compact as my bronzer. You can always buy the deepest shade of compact and use it as your bronzer. This is a really natural looking bronzer. I do really like it. Zooming you guys in, because I'm going to start my eyeshadow. I'm going to use this Swiss Beauty Ultimate Eyeshadow Palette in the shade 08, and I'm taking a purple matte shadow. And this look is, you know, I thought of creating a purple look. I really love purple. If I can do it every day, this will be my everyday sort of, yeah, just this much will be my everyday sort of purple look. So as you can see, I'm going with the windshield wiper motion and the circular motion back and forth. You have to build this shadow. These are not highly pigmented, but these are good for beginners like me, since you know we have to practice, we have to learn. We cannot use a really highly pigmented palette and you know then slowly build the pigmentation. So it's better to opt for a buildable palette and slowly build the pigmentation. And yeah, done my other eye as well, and I'm you know, using this NYB single shadow. I don't remember the shade number, I will definitely mention it. It's a beautiful purple shimmery shade. That's why I did this purple matte crease, because I wanted to use this shimmery shade. And as you can see with the finger, the shade was not looking that you know beaming. So what I did, I just wet my fingers. Now can you guys see this? Instantly looks so metallic. And don't worry, the when the setting spray will you know I will you know evaporate, this will look really beautiful. And as you can see with finger, the pigmentation was okay, but once I wet my finger, the pigmentation was like 10 times better. So yeah, so now I will use a kajal. I'm using this L18 kajal. This was just ₹76 and it is like jet black and a good kajal. And I smudged it, so I cannot comment on the longevity, but I will tell you, like on me, since I don't have watery eyes and I have dry skin, so every kajal stays for a really long time. So yeah, now I'm going to just smudge that kajal a little bit, because this you know eye looks you know need some bold liner, I feel that. So for mascara, I'm using this Blue Heaven Lash Twist curling mascara, and you will see in just one coat, this will you know give you that not falsies kind of effect, but it will really coat your lashes, separates them, and will provide you some volume. And my lashes was looking so good in just single coat. So yeah, I really like this mascara a lot. And this was just like ₹88 on discount. And as you can see, even on camera, this is visible. Usually on camera, you know, mascaras are not sometimes even visible. I was having zero expectations from this one. Now I'm going to use the Touch of Spice by Maybelline. And I'm going to go with the Inset Cosmetic Gloss, and this is in the shade Temptation. So yeah, now I'm going to go with the matte blush. This is the LA Color Red Rouge blush in the shade Awesome. As this look was purple, so I thought of you know going with a mauve blush, and this is a really pretty mauve blush. And now I'm going to again go with the highlighter, because that highlighter was barely visible. So now I'm using the Blue Heaven Makeup Fixer. Always, you know, hide your eyes, otherwise it can mess up your eye look. So here is the final result, you guys. I do like the eye. I was scared to use, you know, colorful shadows, but I think it was looking decent. And here's the closer. And yeah, do let me know how you think about this eye look. I think I created a decent eye look for, you know, first colorful attempt. I will definitely try to improve myself. So yeah, I hope you would like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up, like, share, subscribe, and I shall see you in my next video.